Senator Jim DeMint shocked a lot of people last week when he announced he was stepping down from the U.S. Senate. As Governor Nikki Haley decides who she will choose to fill the rest of DeMint's term, his entire staff is now looking for work.
Hi, Ms. Jones. This is Jesse from Senator DeMint's office. How are you today?
The days here are now numbered.
You know, these things last for 6 years, and, you know, when you come into it, and it doesn't last 6 years. It's a surprise.
Senator DeMint's office, this is Seth.
Seth Blanton serves as a staff member for Senator Jim DeMint in his Greenville office. He and others found out last week, to their surprise, that the senator was stepping down effective January 1st. They say they're happy for the senator, but...
Also some sadness, though, because we've come to the end of the road in this service, and it's been a really incredible ride.
Danielle Gibbs has been with the senator for a decade now. She started as an intern. Now she is responsible for much of the work in the Greenville office.
As I was blown away by the people here who wanted to help a child get a medical visa to come to America and have a service performed that they could not have in their home country. To see the senator pin a medal on a veteran for the first time who never got honored for his service.
Kind of keep an eye on our website.
Much of that continues even now.
And especially the news on who Governor Haley may appoint to this position.
The staff of about five people is busy trying to respond to more than 1,000 constituent issues.
And we've got to finish all 1,200 of those well, be it transitioning to another member or wrapping those up as quickly as possible. So the work's not over.
And we'll still be here for the next several weeks.
Busy helping others, while at the same time, these Senate staffers have to set aside time to also take care of themselves. And they do have a little more time. Senate rules give staffers 60 days of pay after the senator's official last day on the job. DeMint will take over as president of the Republican think tank and lobbying group, the Heritage Foundation.